Lesson number 1025. The 26th lesson on Hajj. We discuss Medina Munawwara today. That Anas bin Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu has said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he left for Hijrat, leaving Makkah Mukarramah, coming to Medina Munawwara, then there was a darkness in Makkah Mukarramah. And when Nabi alayhi salam came to Medina Munawwara, then naturally it was very, very light and illuminated. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that it is the right of the believer that he comes and he visits Medina Munawwara. This hadith is made mention of in Abu Dawud. And definitely a person, he should try and go to Medina Munawwara because this is the place whereby Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is resting. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said in another hadith that that person that comes to Medina Munawwara only with the intention of visiting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and reward, and he presents himself and he reads salam to me, then inshallah on the day of Qiyamah I will intercede for such a person. This hadith is made mention of in Bayhaqi. Another hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that this person that makes Hajj and after Hajj comes to Medina Munawwara to make ziyarat of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the masjid, that person will get the reward of two Hajj. This hadith is made mention of in Dahlami. There's a fourth hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that that person that comes to Medina Munawwara and presents himself to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala restores the soul of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he responds to the salam. This hadith is made mention of by Imam Ahmad rahimahullah in his Musnad. Although from a scholarly perspective, some of these ahadith have weak narrations, but obviously the reward is there by visiting Medina Munawwara. In conclusion, let us listen to these four advices. The one advice is that if a person is not happy with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given a person, then tell that person he should find another sustainer who can give him that much. The second thing, that if a person is commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not to do something, then a person should do it. Otherwise he should leave the place where the rulership and the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. The third thing is that the person should avoid disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Otherwise, that person should go and disobey Allah in such a place whereby Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot see the person. And the fourth thing is that a person should worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if he feels that he doesn't want to do this, then he should not give from the sustenance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is given him. So although these four are impossible, so then the converse of that is also true. Remain happy with Allah as your sustainer. Do not do the things Allah has stopped you. Then disobey Allah and be perpetual in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah give us the understanding. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.